Hi, I am Dr. Leela Mohan, PVR. I am an internal medicine consultant and physician. I mainly practice in motherhood and Manipal. I have my own center called as Padithem Healthcare, that is in HSR layout, Bangalore. Hemophilia is a rare genetic disorder which is mainly caused due to the deficiency of the clotting factors. So what are the clotting factors? Clotting factors are nothing but there are certain proteins in our body. Due to the deficiency of these proteins, the hemophilia will be caused. So hemophilia is of two types mainly, that is hemophilia A and hemophilia B, and usually it mainly caused due to the deficiency of clotting factors, as I said. So the hemophilia A is mainly caused due to the deficiency of the clotting factor 8, and the hemophilia B will be caused due to the deficiency of the clotting factor 9. So what is this hemophilia basically? It is a genetic disorder, as I told. It is inherited from the parents to the children. So usually the male chromosomes, that means like the X chromosome, who is carrying, the male usually carries the X chromosome. So they will be developing the disease, as where here the females will be the carriers. So usually the females will not be affected so much as males. So symptoms are mainly excessive bleeding. So what is this excessive bleeding? If a person falls down, or if the patient, or if the person undergoes a surgery, the bleeding will not stop as usual like in the normal person. And the joint pains and the inflammation of the joints, the people who will be suffering with hemophilia will be having mainly the joint pains regularly. Once they get up in the morning, sometimes they feel stiffness. There are other certain symptoms which are very common with the hemophilia. And easy bruising, what we'll call it as, without any fall or without any injury to the person, the patient can develop bleeding inside the body. So the bleeding can go and get accumulated in the joints, and which leads to the pain in the joints and also causes the inflammation in the joints. So the diagnosis, mainly we'll do the blood testing. There are certain tests which we'll do in the blood to identify the clotting factors. It will be helpful in finding out which is the deficient clotting factor in the blood of the patient. And the genetic testing, this is the next level testing. When we get a suspicious of the above symptoms, what I had told up to now, then we'll go for the genetic testing, and or also we'll call it as genetic screening. So these are the both main diagnostic tests which will be helpful in finding out the hemophilia. So the treatment mainly includes the symptomatic treatment. If the patient is having the pain, NSAIDs, that is called as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, but this will be the temporary treatment. And the deficient clotting factors we'll identify, and we'll infuse the clotting factor transfusion or infusion into the body of the patient so that the person will not develop hemophilia. And other than that, physical activity, regular physiotherapy, there are certain other treatment. So avoiding certain medications like aspirin and all is very important. And what I suggest you is, whenever you go to your doctor or meet the doctor, if any history of hemophilia or any other drug allergies, please mention towards to your healthcare professional so that they'll not prescribe you aspirin and all. Aspirin also causes bleeding, and then it can lead to more severe form of hemophilia. So World Hemophilia Day is nothing but on 17th April. This is basically, it is not celebrated, actually it is done. And then it is mainly maintained by the World Federation of Hemophilia, that is WFH, which is mainly concentrates on the patient's health, and it will help in identifying the patients who are developing the hemophilia, or before marriage, or before getting into relationships, taking the blood samples, and for the genetic testing they will send. And then if any clotting factor deficiency or if anything is there, they will identify before itself, and they'll inform to the people. There are certain good activities which will be carrying by this World Federation of Hemophilia. That's mainly celebrated on 17th April. Genetic counseling to the patients. So what does this genetic counseling means? Like if the patients are suffering, or if the parents are having hemophilia, they give education material, and they'll make aware of the things like how it goes on. It is mainly observed by World Federation of Hemophilia. There is a society which mainly helps in people treating this hemophilia.